Total solar irradiance, TSI, the dominant historical gauge for solar climate effect. While we know that thanks to 400 solar forcing papers since 2011 that the breadth of solar forcing in the future will be more appropriately applied, capped off with Mathis et al. 2017, which we covered earlier this year. But perhaps you are wondering why it matters or how you can get your head around why it's so vital that this not remain the gauge of solar forcing on our climate. In case you didn't yet catch the timeline at the bottom, we're looking at the last 2 months of total solar irradiance data, and the thing that sticks out is that a few weeks ago we had a large drop in TSI, almost equivalent to the change expected over the entire 11-year sunspot cycle due to the higher and lower periods of sunspots. What is interesting is that while TSI does go up during sunspot maximum, we see a dramatic drop during the strongest space weather events. That dip there indeed occurred during the major solar flare uptick of September 2017. If that seems contradictory to you and to the notion of potential Earth climate effects, you are right. But despite the fact that this is not uncommon, in fact, many surges in solar activity result in a drop in TSI, it is still considered the basis for saying the sun has no effect on climate change. Well, if the ultraviolet energy drops in favor of X-ray and charged particle bombardment, that seems like something that should be more heavily weighed towards climate effect, not hidden by the method we choose to judge the sun. Well, that is what we are talking about. That's what is important about 400 solar forcing papers, and especially Mathis et al. 2017. The feedbacks, oscillation controls, charge particle, and geoelectric effects are now indisputable, and when we transition away from a strictly TSI model, it can only serve to benefit the climate models. One should not expect this to erase the human effects in those models, but perhaps the failure of current models to predict global temperatures without the benefit of record El Niños will be reduced with better accounting of all the different factors involved in our complex climate system.